This is a remote island. Like, look at this. We're gonna look through some tide pools and see what we could find over here on the Virgin Islands. This is a tide pool.
Just look at these views on views, man. This is crazy.
Oh yeah, baby. Look at that brittle star right here.
Right there.
Oh. What is going on, Cuffaro? Welcome back to another video. Although I'm here at the farm right now with the pigs, we are actually traveling 1,140 miles away for today's video. Smash that like button, and without further ado, we are here in St. Thomas. It is beautiful. Virgin Islands, getting foggy because I'm up here in the elevation of a mountain. Does that make any sense? I don't know. We're gonna look through some tide pools and see what we can find over here on the Virgin Islands. This is a remote island. Like, look at this. We are out here in the middle of the ocean. Well, I guess that's what an island is, right? Beautiful from the Airbnb view. I feel like I am on top of the world. First things first, we're gonna go snorkel. We have a couple different spots we wanna snorkel, but we're gonna start off at a random little beach in Magans Bay. So without further ado, enjoy the first snorkel to then go to the even crazier snorkel to then tide pools. First dive, St. Thomas, let's go.
This place is truly beautiful.
It is filled with the most beautiful colored fish, obviously octopus, stingrays,
turtles we've seen already. It's crazy. And then look at the view.
Doesn't get much better than that. I mean, I swam all the way right here to the edge, and there's cactuses and stuff up there. And all sorts of stuff that you typically just don't see. You know, it's cool to go on vacation. I say vacation, but look, I'm still working. There's just random chickens that walk around. Hey buddy, you're real cool looking. Want to come back to the PC farm? All right, take that as a no. Oh, there's another one. Oh, and another one. There's three chickens. Four chickens. They're everywhere. It doesn't get much quite nicer than that right there. Trunk Bay in St. John. Right, Tay?
USVI.
Yeah. It was a mission to get here though. We took the ferry, and then from the ferry, we took the taxi cab.
Bus cab taxi thing. Now to the spot. Okay, snorkeling those rocks is gonna be gas. That's where we're going. Oh right down there. Oh my God, look, a monkey.
I'm just kidding. And then from the taxi cab, we took that here. But this is probably the clearest water I've ever seen. I mean, it's ridiculous. And even at home, we have clear water. This is clear. So we're gonna go snorkel this beautiful reef out there. Apparently there's a bunch of coral and reef fish and stuff like that. We're gonna find out. We are at the next spot, Trunk Bay Beach.
And we have a little underwater trail.
The water is as clear as I've ever seen in my life. Look at this. It's ridiculous. It doesn't even look real.
There's a bunch of pens
eating on
some sort of coral.
Thank you. When have we seen views like this on the PC channel before? Because, never. We are here at another random beach. We actually walked down a little jungle trail to get here. But now we're working our way over to what we hope to find, fish and crabs and invertebrates and whatever we could possibly find inside these tide pools. We are where I don't think any other YouTuber's ever filmed a tide pool video, that's a fact. There is all sorts of stuff, and to start off our search, look right here.
He's actually drying up.
Oh yeah, baby. First thing is a sea urchin. We're gonna actually put him back in the water.
Look at the other ones right there. There's more in the rocks. Oh, there's another one right there.
We'll put him right there and let him find his way. But we're on the hunt for anything we could possibly find, Cuffaros. I've never done a video like this, ever. This is a first. We did some snorkeling earlier in the most beautiful crystal clear water ever. And obviously now we are looking in tide pools. A tide pool is, I don't know the exact definition, but I can give you a rundown. The waves will come over these rocks, break, and actually fill in this right here. Now when the tide goes back out, this is still full of water until the tide gets high enough to cover this again. So the fish, invertebrates, whatever may be in here are stuck in here. So you can see a bunch of little sergeant majors right there. I mean, underwater, they're just chilling right there in the little hole. We're gonna definitely find some cool stuff. Just look at these views on views, man. This is crazy. Much nicer than where I'm from, that's a fact. Although where I live is absolutely beautiful, and we have a lot of cool stuff there too. Jacob, let me know if you find anything, man.
I got you,
buddy. Oh, don't step on a sea urchin out here, because we are far from a hospital, I promise you that. We hiked a mile to get here. See, the waves are breaking over. We need to find the juice. If I had a net, this would be a lot more easy to catch things. Dude, look at this pool. Anything could be swimming in this hole for all we know.
Look at this little guy.
A little hermit crab. And this is a little tide pool, for instance. So there's this hermit crab in the tide pool.
See another sea urchin.
And nothing else that I see. But all these little holes could possibly carry fish. Sheesh! I'm no snail guy, but that's a big old snail if you ask me. Looks like one of them Mexican turbo snails.
I'm gonna put him right there.
So long, brother. Little feather duster up in that one. It's kind of crazy though. This is like river rock throughout here.
I don't even feel like I'm in an ocean, I'm gonna be honest. I'm literally like hiking through the side of these mountains.
Here we go. We found some more tide pools, check this out. Oh yeah, Jacob.
Look at all the gobies, oh my gosh.
This is the definition of a tide pool. First of all, look at this creek right here. Some fish down over there, but I gotta show you this. Look at that. This is a tide pool. The tide rose, it filled this in, and then it dropped back down, and now this, if anything was to be in here, will be trapped until the tide switches back.
There's gobies all up in this tide pool. There's one, sitting on the rock right there.
So as we find more and more tide pools, what we're finding is goby. They look like this. If you don't know what a goby is, we're finding thousands of them.
Look at that beautiful little damsel.
Yeah. Oh, right there.
Oh, did they get that on video?
Oh my God, look at the star.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that brittle star right here. That's sick.
Hurry.
Wham away.
That's so sick. I'm not gonna bug them. It's in a good spot. Look at these things too. These crazy leech looking things.
Whoa,
look at these. I've never seen anything like that. If anyone knows what those are, comment down below.
What?
I think I got it on video.
Right there.
It is wild looking at those things.
Oh, it's so creepy. So although I wish we could have seen a little bit more action in these tide pools, if you guys want to see more stuff like this, just smash the like button and I will fly back out to the next location and try to do another remote island tide pool search, or we could do this even at home. This was interesting though. We saw all sorts of stuff. Snails, bristle star, this eel looking snake thing. I don't even know what it was. I hope I got it on camera. Sergeant majors, gobies, all sorts of stuff. It was an awesome experience, and don't forget, snorkeled and saw so many amazing, beautiful species. So if you did make it to this point of the video, I'm sure you enjoyed it. I'm happy you made it this far because you saw all sorts of stuff. You took this trip along with me. Honestly, I could have probably found a lot more if I just kept walking, but it's like 115 degrees out and I'm dying. I haven't had water yet. So thank you all so much, Cuffaros, for watching this different video for sure. Typically, you know, we're on the farm or doing a project at home, so it's definitely different. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace from St. Thomas. We'll be right back. people know when you take B-roll, you gotta go back and get the camera. And my feet are on fire!